judgment of the heart. No passion itself has left me. And delight in fastidious choice. My mind beats on. Silent graveyard. And the silent dead. Yes, from the black rectangular hole in the ground. Light everlasting, would that the light of inspiration had not left.
Oh, this is earth that fills thy tires.
a thirst, a leaping wild unrest, a deep desire.
No boundaries hold you. Go travel to the south. Great poets, before you have listened to its voice.
Gone! He's gone, as suddenly as he came. The traveller from beyond the Alps. Should I go to beyond the mountains? Should I let impulse be my guide? Should I give up the fruitless struggle with the wet? A close watch over my development as a writer, over my behavior as a man. Should I now, without thought, break my habit, my summer of work in the mountains, to holiday in the warm and lovely south? The break can be justified, of course, by this growing fatigue that no one must suspect, and that I must not betray by any sign of flagging inspiration. Yes, it can be justified, but the truth is that it has been precipitated by a sudden desire for the unknown. So be it. I will pursue this freedom and offer up my days to the sun and the south. My ordered soul shall be refreshed at last.
Trouble is, do I
boy? Doesn't know what trouble is, doesn't know.
welcome that my Venice us in mind. And by the way, I love too the pretty little darling, 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 the pretty little darling, don't you
Passengers must follow.
Ambiguous Venice.
Follow where I lead. No choice for the living, no choice for the dead.
Where is the man going? I want to go to Schiavone.
The Signore is going to the Lido.
Yes, by Vaporetto.
The Signore cannot go by Vaporetto. The Vaporetto does not take baggage.
That is my affair. You will turn round.
vanish help in me. I go where I choose. I go my own way, I have nothing to lose.
Is it money he's after?
The signore will pay.
I will pay nothing if you do not take me where I want to go.
To the Lido.
But not with you.
I know you well.
True heroes well. I shall leave him alone.
They know how I go there.
Go back to my dream.
They take what I give.
To the sway of the golden eagle.
Shall kill me not while I live. To please.
Buongiorno, signore. Piano, piano.
This way, signore. Prego.
One moment, please. I have not paid the gondolier.
Why, he's gone. Gone without his money.
He made off, signore. A bad lot.
He was recognized here. A bad lot.
A man we don't trust.
A man without a license.
But the signore is lucky. He had his gondola right for nothing. Mysterious gondola. Different world surrounds you. A timeless, legendary world of dark, lawless errors in the watery night. How black a gondola is, black coffin black. A vision of death itself and the last silent voyage. Yes, he rode me well, but he might have done for me, rode me across the Styx. Then I should have faded, faded like echoes, echoes in the lagoon to nothing.
Pleasant journey. He will have a pleasant sojourn. I am jacks and the lace. And here is the room as you commanded, and look, signore, the view. The view of the beach from our rooms is superb, from this one especially.
Venice once again. Egregio Signor von Aschenbach. The writer who has found a way to reconcile art and honors, the lofty purity of whose style has been officially recognized, and who has accepted, even welcomed, the austere demands of maturity. Yes, I turned away from the paradox and daring of my youth, renounced bohemianism and sympathy with the outcast soul, to concentrate upon simplicity, beauty, oh, upon these all my art is built. Now, in this beautiful, agreeable place, I intend to give myself to the leisured world for a spell. A pleasant journey, did he say? The whole experience was odd, unreal, out of normal focus. Was I wrong to come? What is there in store for me? Thank you. Such beauty come about? What mysterious harmony between the individual and the universal law produces such perfection of form? Would the child be less good, less valuable as a human being if he were less beautiful? The fact is that in that disciplined family, beauty dominates. The severe, plain little girls must be quiet, demure. The elegant boy may show off his grace. No doubt but mamma, with her fabulous pearls, indulges herself in a pampering, partial love. Just as I indulge myself in these novelist speculations. There is indeed in every artist nature a wanton and treacherous proneness to side with beauty.
Thank you.
The sea, immeasurable, unorganized, void. I long to find rest in perfection. And is not this a form of perfection? Eros, his very self. I was not mistaken. It is very good. So the little Polish god is proud, proud like all his race. He is human after all. From Taddeus, short for Taddeus, Tadjo. Oh, my little beauty, you notice when you're noticed, you notice when you're noticed, do you? Of language, the slender forms of an art. I might have created him. Perhaps that is why I feel a father's pleasure, a father's warmth in the contemplation of him. Yes, Aschenbach, you have grown reserved, self-sufficient since the death of a wife and marriage of an only daughter. Dependent not upon human relationships, but upon work and again work. How much better to live not words, but beauty. To exist in it and of it. How much better than my detached and solitary way.
Guida, Guida, let me guide the signore. I can find him places he doesn't know, places to delight him.
While the Scirocco blows, nothing delights me. My head is heavy, my eyelids ache.
Guardi, signore, see the beautiful silks and lace. Tutto peccato.
Venga qui, signore, look at my beautiful glass. Tutto peccato.
Tutto
peccato.
Foul exhalations rise under the bridges, oppress my breathing, dispel my joy.
La carità, il padre sick, the bambini are hungry. La carità,
Gabaretti, Mazanette, the train to Como. Gone, gone to Como. That is not where I'm going.
Sorry, signore.
Mi dispiace, signore.
You must fight it, get it back. Without it, I cannot go. You understand? I cannot go. I shall return to the hotel. Arrange for the baggage to be sent back there.
Very good, signore. In the twinkling of an eye, it shall be back. Gondoliere, to the Lido at once.
Of my early heroes, passive in the face of fate. What do I really want? First, I am grief-stricken, but must go because of the danger to my health. Then I am furious because I am forced to return. But secretly I rejoice, vacillating, irresolute, absurd. Experience has been disruptive to my thoughts and to my work. Yet, in spite of it, I feel my spirits rise. Often, what is called disruptive is not directed against life, but is invigorating, a renewal.
my days to the sun, to the sun, and Apollo himself.
Yeah. Too late! I couldn't do it!
this is frenzy absurd. The heat of the sun must have made me ill. So longing passes back and forth between life and the mind. To this, I can find no better description of my state than the hackneyed words. I love you, overcome by beauty
I tried quite simply to use the emotion released for my own creation. What I wrote was good, quite what was expected of me, to the point, yet poignant. But when it was done, I felt degraded, as if I had taken part in an orgy. Then I was moved to put this relationship, if so one-sided an affair can be called a relationship, onto a natural footing. I would hail the boy, exchange a few words with him. I couldn't do it. My beating heart and trembling limbs refused to obey my will. So I had to mock myself as the crestfallen lover. Understands the workings of the creative mind. Nonetheless, so be it. This I love you must be accepted. Ridiculous, but sacred too, and no, not dishonorable. Even in these circumstances.
Guardate, signore, va bene, signore. Move the head to the left. Yes. Weather is idyllic, too hot, just a trifle, the hotel gets a fewer. Guardate, signore, va bene, signore, your head down if you please. But what was that you're saying? You hear this German? Ah, your compatriots are always very careful. Ah, it's so nice, take the phone back. I've tended to have a bit of many sums. A splendid affair, if I may say so. Remarkable for someone in his middle years and such a youthful skin. Guardate, signore, in sheer they spend the summer with us. Va bene, signore. But now, after 10 days, they have gone back to the cold and welcoming north. Hit up just a little. He does not fear the sickness, does he?
Sickness? Sickness? What sickness?
Nothing. I know nothing.
But you mentioned it.
It is not important. It is nothing.
You must know what you mean.
Take a note to say it is not important. You fancy this oil, sir, a delectable censer. The signore now takes little interest in such things. That is it, signore. Next week at the same time. Va bene, signore. Egregio signore. Prego, prego.
Sickness. What sickness? Than a malaise from the Scirocco, a sickness to drive people away.
Mm-hmm. that.
Citizens are advised to take precautions against infection. Citizens are advised not to eat shellfish in this unusually hot season. Citizens must not use the canal waters for household purposes.
Fathers are seldom so solicitous. What is this sweetish smell that pervades the air, my friends?
Scusi.
What are these warnings?
Just a formal precaution, sir. A least regulation, sir, with which we must conform.
Quite unimportant, sir. Precaution, real. Let me guide the signor.
Basta, basta!
Signore, buona carità, the bambini are sick. Giornali tedeschi il mondo. German newspapers.
Das Tagblatt. Grazie.
Grazie, signore, la stampa. Giornali inglesi, il mondo, la stampa. Giornale.
Rumors of cholera in Venice, officially denied. Rumors of an incipient plague in Venice, officially denied. Ah, here it is! We doubt the good faith of the Venetian city fathers in their refusal to admit to the cases of cholera in the city. German citizens should return as soon as possible. Ah, rumors, 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 they should be silent. The city secret growing darker every day, like the secret in my own heart. They must receive no hint. They must not be told.
Thank you. untroubled face, hide the panic fear, yet have I driven on.
Thank you. decent stern men, in whose respectable name and under whose influence you, the artist, made the life of art into a service, a hero's life of struggle and abstinence. When heroes have flourished, heroes has flourished too. It was no shame to them to be enthralled. Rather, it brought them praise, it brought them honor.
This way for the playlist,
this way.
Waiting, and mind you, not a word.
peso al giasso e ne agosto ne rigar.
Le vecchie le sua
troveron de in terra ferra e fuori
most urgent
information.
One word.
beggar leave for tonight.
Oh, my dear young man, I said today,
four places, first class.
And marriage, if you please.
Oh, your scars, port to France, urgent business. I cannot wait.
I'm sorry, signori.
Takes precautions in this weather.
Is that the truth?
More fear.
now. Madam, I will say, allow a perfect stranger to give you a warning. Madam, I will say, go away at once. You are in danger. Venice is in the grip of the plague. Do you not see how everyone is leaving? You must go too with your daughters and with Dionysus. Madam, I will say, madam. Everything decent and above board. Missed the opportunity to become myself again. Missed the opportunity to regain my reason, my self-possession. But what is self-possession? What is reason, moral sense? What is art itself compared to the rewards of chaos? The city's secret, desperate, disastrous, destroying, is my hope. What if all were dead, and only we two left alive? It is all true. I can fall no further. Oh, the taste of knowledge, of knowledge. Let the gods do what they will with me.
Decision, if I may say so. One should not neglect oneself in one's middle life. Everyone should make a stand against advancing years. Guardate, signore, egregio signore. Crave, oh, just a trifle. Due to lack of interest, you would not neglect your health, your teeth. Then why refuse the use of cosmetics, cosmetics? Nothing ages a man like grey hair. Permit me to aid it just a little, just a little. Very wise. Magnificent. Oh, the difference. Prego, 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 prego!
Overripe. Chaos, chaos and sickness. What if all were dead, and only we two left alive? Oh, Aschenbach, famous as master, self-discipline, your strength, all folly, all pretence. Oh, perilous, perilous sweetness. The wisdom poets crave. Socrates knew. Socrates told. Senses can pose.
simplicity and discipline. But this is beauty, Phaedrus, discovered through the senses, and senses lead to passion, Phaedrus, and passion to the abyss. And now, Phaedrus, I will go, but you stay here, and when your eyes no longer see me, then you go too.
Return to their home in the cold. beyond the mountains.
Well,
after luncheon, to be sure. Yes, Signor von Aschenbach, the season comes to an end. So lose what we think to enjoy the moment.